Congress President Rahul Gandhi said that the Gujarat election were a zabardast jhatka to the BJP and raised questions about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's credibility after a narrow victory. The Congress party has won the majority of seats in the by-elections to Zilla Parishads, Panchayat Samitis and Municipal Wards in Rajasthan. After the successful temple runs in Gujarat, Congress President Rahul Gandhi is expected to continue employing the soft Hindutva strategy in election-bound Karnataka. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee today called up Patidar leader Hardik Patel and congratulated him for his tremendous work in Gujarat Assembly election. Audi India will be launching the new generation Audi Q5 in domestic market on 18 January 2018. The company will be rolling out the updated avatar of Q5 in India after its world premiere at Paris Motor Show 2016. Pakistan has been mobilizing widespread protest and calling on the Arab world to pressurize the United States to revert President Donald Trump's decision of recognizing Jerusalem as capital of Israel. Naxals attacked the Masudan railway station in Bihar and touched the station property, and they have also abducted two railway officials including assistant station master. The dates of Indian Premier League 2018 auction have been finalized. The two-day affairs that will attract the attention of the world's cricket fraternity will be held in Bangalore on January 27 and 28. Infocus has launched its new smartphone, the Infocus Vision 3 in India. The device is available in black color and it costs ₹6,999. OnePlus was founded nearly 4 years ago and the Chinese smartphone brand is now celebrating its fourth anniversary in India by offering offers on smartphones and accessories.